Hello everyone, my name is Emdy and welcome to the first video on my channel. I'm joined by fellow NubTech member Scorpio
Hi guys.
to bring you the NubTech Iron Farm. There are a few parts to this video, so feel free to skip ahead to the sections you want to see. Timestamps are down in the description and the important sections are labeled. This is a poppy and iron farm for the Java edition of Minecraft. Versions 1.17 to 1.18, and it needs some modifications for 1.16. It is heavily inspired by Tango Tek's design, which he built on Hermitcraft Season 8. If you aren't aware of Tango's farm's concept, I'll explain it in brief. Villagers in groups of three are put into multiple launching cells facing a central hostile mob. The cells are launched individually or a number at a time. After a little over 30 seconds, where they are held in place with sight to another hostile mob for 5 seconds, which allows them to spawn their golems on a platform above, out of range of the other villagers, so their cooldowns aren't reset. So you may be wondering, why don't I just build Tango's? His looks simple enough, what's different here? Well, there are a couple of things. First off, cost. Tango's farm uses a lot of dispensers and buckets per module, and as we know, those are painful to craft and set up. These modules only have one dispenser and one bucket each. Second, speed. Launch times are no longer hindered by bubble column formation. Once a module is triggered, the villagers start launching instantly. Third, lag efficiency. The NubTech farm is completely free of redstone dust, and has lag-friendly wiring and covered hoppers to ease the strain on the server, both when idle or running. Fourth, the use of portals, for simplicity and compactness. They can be replaced with bubble columns as shown by Tango, although testing for such a modification has not been done. We encourage you to try.
When a villager is panicking from an attack, or when it sees a hostile mob, such as a pillager who can scare them from 15 blocks away, it searches for two other villagers within 10 blocks in each direction in a cube shape. If it finds two villagers and all three of them have slept within the past in-game day and have not detected a golem within 16 blocks in the past 30 seconds, then the villager attempts to spawn a golem within 6 blocks above and below the villager, and 7 or 8 blocks in the X and Z directions, making 10 such attempts. If the spawn is successful, all the villagers within 10 blocks have their seen golem timers set to 600 game ticks. The scanning for mobs by villagers happens every 20 game ticks, but their individual offsets are selected randomly when loaded. So if the scan happens in the same tick a golem spawns, or the hostile mob comes into view, the scan and the attempt to spawn may fail, which is why this kind of a farm, which relies on simultaneous spawning, is not as efficient as farms which has spread out spawn platforms. When a slice is triggered, moving slime blocks launch the villagers 13 blocks up, where they're held for a little over 5 seconds, which is enough time for them to spawn a golem 4 blocks above their heads. The golem then clips inside a portal and gets teleported in 2 game ticks, which is fast enough for the next module's villager to not detect them when launched. The module, when deactivated, drops the villager down, cancel the fall damage with water and blocks bouncing by closing a fence gate above the villagers. The fall damage needs to be cancelled since they tend to sleep mid-fall and the damage get applied after getting out of bed. The slices of the farm are activated by a 102 game tick clock and an instant wire designed by Kahyxen to make sure they are all in sync, which then powers a dropper line that acts as a selection system.
If you want a super compact iron farm, this is about as good as it gets. For its size, it's one of, if not the fastest iron farm. If you want more rates with this farm, you can tile it with the 30 block gap between them in any direction till you achieve your desired rates. The farm is only about 6 MSPT while running on my i5-11400, most of which is from the villagers themselves. The lamps are optional and purely for looks, Both them and the nearby redstone blocks can be replaced with glass. There is no block-by-block tutorial yet, but if the video gets received well and I get enough requests, I will try my best to make one in the near future. There will be a world download and lightmatics with and without the lamps linked in the description if you would like to build or test it. For information on how to set up the instant wire, refer to Kahyxen's video. Please note that the lightmatic files do not have saved inventories, so when building, remember to place water buckets in all the dispensers and one item in the dropper in front of the slice that has an active comparator in the schematic. If you don't know what lightmatica is and how to use it, I have also linked a video on that below.